Good evening. We welcome you live to the sanctuary of Encounter Church on this wonderful Wednesday night, the night that the Lord has made. Amen. He designed it just for us tonight to be able to engage together and hear the word of the Lord. We believe that God is going to speak to us, and as he speaks to us, we're going to absorb it all together, just like a sponge, to be able to absorb the word that comes forth, not just to be absorbing of it, but to be able to get it to the point where it's drenched so much, our life is drenched in him, that he will wring us out. And the anointing that is upon him, that he puts upon us, we'll be able to wring, he'll be able to wring that out onto somebody else's life. Why? Because our obedience. Why? Because he desires for us to be full and consumed with him. So as tonight, as we gather together, let's anticipate the Spirit of God to continue to speak to us and to give us an ear to hear so that we can absorb everything that he has for us for such a time as this, together as one team, just like our vision, to encounter the presence of God and to equip people of all backgrounds to become disciples of Jesus Christ, laborers for his kingdom, one united loving family, having one heart, with one purpose, together as one team, touching our community and reaching the world. And that's exactly what we're going to do as we continue to allow the Spirit of the Lord, the fire of the Lord, the anointing of the Lord to consume us as we absorb everything that he has for us for such a time as this. So we pray even now, Father, that you would continue to do a work in us, Father God, that you would give us the ears to hear what you have to say to us for tonight, Father God, that we would be a sponge in your presence, Father, so that you can wring us out, Lord, that your anointing will be able to be wrung out within us, Father God, to be able to fall upon others, Lord. And we thank you for your way in us and through us. If you have a youth or a young adult, I encourage you to have them join us tonight at 7:20 as we continue our series, Unanticipated Gift, the gift of Jesus Christ, as we understand from the perspective of the shepherds, how they were responsive to the angel, how they were willing to report what the Lord has done. And tonight, we have an opportunity to gather with the youth via Zoom at 7:20 to allow the Father to continue to speak to us so that they can also, in return, be a sponge. So let's gather together as one team and let's worship the Lord together in Jesus' name.
Yes, amen. I love that. We are together worshiping the Lord. Because it's bigger than just one of us. We have gathered together. So you in your living room, you in your dining room, your kitchen, maybe you're resting on your bed or driving. We are together. And where two or three are gathered, he is in our midst. So tonight, Jesus is in our midst. The Holy Spirit and the Father, yes, yes, they are in our midst. And they are so good and so wonderful, worthy of all praise, glory and honor. You are good, you are good, when there's nothing good in me. You are love, you are love, on display for all to see. You are light, when the darkness closes in. You are hope, you are hope, you have covered all my
like a banner. Raise his name like a banner. He covers all. He covers all sickness. He covers all worry, all fear. He covers you like a blanket. We thank you, Holy Spirit, that you are with us. We sing out that name of Jesus. Oh, you are everything I could ever need. Oh, healing, deliverance, hope and peace and power and joy. Oh, Jesus, my heart will sing. My heart will sing.
Father, we come to you, Father God, to reign over our prayer requests, Father. So if you have a prayer request right now, I invite you to let us know. Why? Because we believe that God is going to reign over our prayer requests. As you engage with us right now, and we engage with the Father in our prayer requests, we believe through us, he would speak to those mountains, that the mountains will be moved for salvations of our family members, for healing in our bodies. In the name of Jesus, Father, we thank you, Father God, for those prayer requests that are coming in right now. Keep them coming because we believe that the Lord is hearing us as a result of your obedience, as a result of you tapping in, as a result of you engaging. Continue for God, for you to restore, Father God, for you to move mountains, Father, in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Father God, right now for everything that you're doing in our lives, Father God. And we thank you, Father God, for every prayer request that is being answered. answered right now because of your people and your body engaging together as one team, Father God. Spirit to spirit, calling out to you, Holy Spirit, right now in the name of Jesus. We lift up right now Sunday service, Father God. We pray, Father God, that you will have your way. We ask for your fire to continue to fall, Father God, over this house and over the houses across America and across this nation and across this world, Father God, for this Sunday, Lord. We lift up the fivefold ministers unto you, Father God. We call them blessed. No weapon formed against them will prosper, Father God. We thank you, Father God, for a word of fire that's going to come forth, Father God, from every pulpit across this nation, Father God, in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Father God, for Apostle Jim and Pastor Joni, Lord. We call them blessed. Their families blessed from the crown of their heads to the soles of their feet, Father. We thank you, Father God, that you will continue, Father God, to raise them up, Lord, into that place where you desire for them to be. We thank you for open doors, Father God, that you're going to open up for them, Father God. And we thank you that they're just going to be able to walk into them, Father. Father, we pray for Chicago. We pray for the cities across this nation, Father. We come against the spirit of violence over these nations, Father God. We come against the spirit, Father God, that is attracting the young adults and the teens to be able to go out and do these things that are contrary to your word across this nation, Father God. We pray right now. We cast those down right now in the name of Jesus. We pray for every government authority, Father God, from the president to the vice president of over every city, over every state, Father God, those in leadership. We call them blessed. We pray, Father God, for godly wisdom. We pray for godly influences. We pray for levels of influence to be able to rise up within the body, Father God, to be able to make an impact and a difference in the lives of those in authority over our government, Father God. We pray, Father God, for this great nation, Father God, for a revival and awakening to sweep across it, Father God, as a result of your body rising up for such a time as this, Father God. We come against, Father God, any of those things, Father God, that are hindering your body from moving forward. For the trajectory is up, Father God. Those things, Father God, that are holding us stale, those things that are keeping us stagnant, we pray, Father God, that you will strip them, Father God, right now in the name of Jesus, because our trajectory is not plain. Our trajectory is not leveled, but our trajectory is up in the kingdom. So we thank you right now, Father God, for every member of Encounter Church, Lord. We call them blessed, Father God. We ask, Lord, for you to continue to have your way in them and through them, Father God, that you would speak to them, Father God, for somebody else, Father God, that we would all be able to walk as one team in obedience to you, Father God. We pray for healing. We pray for revival. We pray, Father God, that you would open up doors, Father God, for them, Father God, and for us as a church, Lord, and for every prayer request right now in the name of Jesus, Lord. We pray, Lord, that you would meet every prayer request, Lord. Every prayer request, Father God. Those that have been written, those that have been spoken out, Father God, to your throne room. We pray, Lord, from our mouth, Lord, to your ears, Lord. According to your will, according to your plan, according to your purpose, Father. Let's stretch our hands right now, church. Let's stretch our hands right now as we engage together. And let's lift up these prayer requests right now, Lord. We thank you, Father, right now in the name of Jesus, Lord, for every prayer request that has gone forth, Lord, in the name of Jesus, answered in the mighty name of Jesus. Those prayer requests that have come forth, Father God, right now, Lord, through the means, Father God, of virtual, Father God, and us being walking in obedience, Lord, and typing these prayer requests, we just ask, Father God, that you, Father God, will answer these needs according to your riches, according to your glory, by your purpose. So right now, as you continue to bring in your prayer requests, we ask, Father God, that you will answer these in the name of Jesus, Lord. We cry out to you together right now, Father God, for every prayer request that has gone forth before your throne, Lord. And we ask, Father God, for your fire, Father God, to fall, Lord. Ultimately, Father God, for answered prayer requests, Lord, for your glory and your glory alone, not for the honor and glory of man, but not for that, Father God, but so that people can see your testimony, Father God. Because our testimony, Father God, is a result of answered prayers.
Yes, Lord.
The testimony of Jesus is the spirit of prophecy. So we thank you, Father God, that we'll be able to walk into that in which you've called us to walk into, Father, for such a time as this, in Jesus' name.
My heart will sing no other name. Oh, it's you, Jesus. Jesus. My heart, it will sing no other name. Jesus. Oh, he is the answer. My heart will sing. My heart will sing.
God, wow, his anointing is real. His anointing is here. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Lord God. The fire of God is in this house. The fire of God is right where you are. Where two or three are gathered, there he is in our midst. You're gathering at home, we're gathering in the sanctuary. But our spirits are gathered together in the mighty name of Jesus. And as Pastor Eddie prayed, let's just take another couple of minutes and continue. That if you have prayer requests, just continue to comment them. If you feel that they're too personal, you can always email the church. But let's take a couple more prayer requests, even if it's just for praying for things in general. Whatever it is, if it's personal and you want to comment it, go ahead. If it's not and you want to just email the church or call the church, you can do that at a later time. But let's just have a couple more people, just if there's others that want to continue to comment, whatever it is, yes, go ahead and do so. There you go. There you go. There you go. There you go. Because in just a minute or two, Pastor Joni will be up here making her announcements. So let's continue to pray. As Pastor Eddie prayed for our nation, the nations. Yep. There we go. There we go. So for all of you right now engaging, in Jesus' name, whatever your prayer request is, whoever you are, wherever you are, we pray right now in Jesus' name for your family. In Jesus' name. For your loved ones. In Jesus' name, as you stand in proxy, we stand and believe with you now. In Jesus' name, now. We declare you well and blessed from the crown of your head to the soles of your feet. From the crown of your head, from the corona. Corona means crown. From the corona of your head to the soles of your feet, we call you blessed and well in Jesus' name. And for no sickness to come nigh you in Jesus' name, nor your dwelling place, your home, we declare that no weapon formed against you shall prosper. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. I declare the blood of Jesus sprinkled over your mind, sprinkled over your heart and over your body in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, yes, Lord. To God be the glory. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Father. Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Sing, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Your presence makes me whole. Declare it now, church. Let it be your prayer. Jesus. Oh, Jesus. For America,
Jesus.
For you and your loved ones,
Jesus.
For your children and grandchildren, for your mind,
Jesus.
For your heart, your eyes, your ears, your nose, your mouth, your entire being, for your family, for those that you're standing in proxy for, for those you're standing in proxy for. Oh, gee. No sickness come near you in Jesus' name. And if it has, it's got to die now. It's got to go. It's got to go. Oh, Jesus, we believe now. We believe His presence makes you whole. We believe His presence makes you whole. Your presence makes me whole. Your presence, Your presence makes me whole. Oh, it's Your presence, Lord. Your presence makes me whole. Let's just sing, Your presence makes us whole. Your presence makes us whole. One last time, us. Your presence makes us whole. Thank You, Father. Thank You for healing our land. Thank You for blessing our church and all the members the way You do, Lord. Thank You for what You did this past Sunday, Lord. Woo!
Hallelujah.
For what You're doing now, Father.
Yes. Thank You, Lord.
For what You're doing now, Father, we give You the glory in Jesus' name. Yes, so we thank You, Father, for Hybrid Church, those engaging online, Lord God, through the source and the power of electricity, through social media, and us here in the sanctuary. And Lord, may this Christmas season be unique and different, that many will be one to You.
Yes.
In Jesus' name.
Hallelujah. Yes.
Amen.
Yes, my God.
Amen. Now Pastor Joni's gonna come and she's going to make some announcements. Pastor Derek, I'm glad that you are healed.
Amen.
And look, both those hands. Look
both
at them.
Of them.
Both of them.
Hallelujah.
Thank You, Lord.
Yes. And there are many that are still on quarantine. On quarantine. They're still in quarantine. But we're getting good reports that they're doing well. And we look forward to seeing them on Sunday.
Yes.
Sunday's coming.
Yes.
Glory to God. Thank You, Lord Jesus. Love You all so much. But we pray that this Christmas season, many of our families will give their life to Jesus.
Yes, yes.
And those that have walked away will come back.
Amen.
Somebody comment, they're coming back.
Yes.
Let me see that. They're coming back. Yes, they are. Our loved ones are coming back. Whether it's our children, our grandchildren, our nieces, our nephews,
yes,
they're coming back. Yes, Lord, they're coming back. Yep. Thank You, Father, in Jesus' name. And speaking about coming back, my wife for life.
Woo-hoo!
She hasn't left, but she's here.
I've come back.
Love you.
Bless you. Love you.
Love you.
Good evening, church. God bless you. So happy to be with you tonight. I love Wednesday nights. They're just very anointed, and I just love how the Holy Spirit just touches us, and does something wonderful within, in, and out. God bless you. God bless you this night. So we have some news that I want to tell you about our Christmas gatherings and what we're going to be doing with our service. But before I go on, I just want to speak a little bit about this past Sunday and how this past Sunday was such a remarkable service. It was remarkable in many, many ways. And one way, it was historical. For me, it was very historical because of what God spoke into Pastor Eddie and Kayleen's life about the future, for the future of Encounter Church. And if you did not get to see that service, I really, really encourage you to watch that service from start to finish, because God did something special that really involves you, especially too, because you're involved with Encounter Church. So, and even if you're not, it will bless you so much, because God did something so incredible. But beside that, it was like the glory of the Lord fell in the house. Before anything even really happened, it was like the glory of God filled this space, and we were just so blessed by that. Lives were touched, words of knowledge went forth, and people's lives were touched, bodies were touched. I believe that there was so much that took place in the spirit realm that was not even mentioned, but God did it, and we're just so blessed by that. So we are a church that invites the Holy Spirit to come, and we are just so blessed by when he touches us, especially on Sunday, the way he did and the way he showed up. It was really, really remarkable and historical. But you'll have to check it out, but it was really cool. So we just thank God for that and for everything that took place. It was really cool. Alrighty, so next Sunday we're meeting right here, and we'll have our 10 o'clock sharp service, and it's going to take place this Sunday, 10 o'clock sharp, and it's going to be amazing and awesome, and we're just going to see what the Holy Spirit does again, right? And so also I wanted to let you know, on Friday, December 24th, because here we are, we're entering the Christmas week. But on Friday, December 24th, we're going to have a Christmas Eve service. So that's going to be from 3 to 4 p.m. And that's going to be live in person. So live in person on Friday, December 24th, 3 to 4, okay? And then because of those who are catching the healing, and because too what my husband had just mentioned a little bit ago, we are going to do our family Christmas service on December 26th, which is the following week. So it's going to be just a day after Christmas, but at 10 o'clock sharp. Santa is going to meet Jesus that day. We have gifts for everyone. It's our family Christmas service. So we'll be right here 10 o'clock sharp. It's going to be awesome. And then we're in preparation for our annual service of Prophetic Night of Destiny is going to be taking place on December 31st. So it's going to be from 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. Alrighty. Candlelight Holy Communion is going to take place as well. And we're going to be live in person for that service as well. So it's going to be awesome. It's going to be amazing. And we just are inviting the Holy Spirit to come and have a part in each and every one of these services, in each and every one of your lives. And we just know that he's going to show up, and we're just excited to see how he's going to show up, right? But so that's what's going on. But I encourage you, please continue to check your emails regularly, because especially with, this little details of and change in a little bit of things. So you want to make sure you stay up to speed with your emails, okay? Alrighty, well, I love you and God bless you. You guys are awesome, and I'm so proud of you. And pressing in is just, it's not just a word to say, it's just not a quote, but pressing in counts, right? Pressing in pays off. So I just want to encourage you to keep pressing in, whether it's in your personal life or whether it's right now, just pressing into what the Lord has for you. It's going to pay off rich, rich, rich dividends, I really believe. God bless you. Love you.
Amen.
Amen.
I love you too.
I love you.
So just to recap, mm-hmm. this Sunday right here in the sanctuary,
right
10 a.m. sharp, mm-hmm.
Children's Ministry.
And then, of course, the following Wednesday night.
Right. We'll have our Wednesday Facebook Live. week from tonight.
A week from tonight, right. Mm-hmm. And then our Christmas Eve service.
Right.
It's going to be on the 24th, right here in person.
From 3 to 4.
From 3 to 4. Mm-hmm. Now, those of you out of town, you can engage online. That's in 3 to 4, our
That's
Christmas
right.
Eve service.
Right.
Right. And then the 26th.
I know December 26th.
It's the day after Christmas, but like Pastor Joni said, for those that were catching their healings,
right.
And by the way, they're all doing well.
Amen. Thank God.
I said all doing well.
Amen.
But part of the quarantine. So we're going to have, like you said, our family Christmas service
right.
on the 26th, 10 a.m. sharp.
Again, gifts for everybody.
Gifts for everybody.
Santa meets Jesus.
I'm going to share a Christmas story. It's going to be awesome.
Mm-hmm.
But then again, like you said, our Night of Destiny.
Right. Mm-hmm.
It's a little different
December
this year.
December 31st.
Yeah, it was a little different last year, too.
It sure was.
But this year, at least, we're going to meet in person from mm-hmm. 7 to 9.
Yes.
Usually, we start like at 10 o'clock at night, and we go into the new year.
Right.
Well, this year, it's going to be a little different, but it will be live in person from 7 to 9.
Right.
And until things start to change a little bit in America and with everything with COVID. For now, this is the way we're going to do it from 7 till 9,
mm-hmm.
live here in person.
Candlelight Holy Communion.
Candlelight Holy Communion. And if
what a great way to start off the new year.
What a great way.
What a great way to close out.
Close out.
2021, and a
yes.
great way to
yes.
lead into 2022.
Yes. And if you think the prophetic was strong this past Sunday.
Oh, my. Yes. I know that. There was a real flavor of what takes place at Night of Destiny was happening this past Sunday. So, I mean, for what took place this past Sunday, how it was historical, it was remarkable, it was marvelous, it was amazing, it was anointed. I can't wait for Night of Destiny because I know
yes.
it's going to be so cool.
Yes, and I'm going to have corporate prophetic words.
Cool.
And I'm going to have individual prophetic words. God's already given you a word for Pastor Derek and Amy.
Oh, good.
And for other people individually in
Thank
the church
you, Lord.
As well. But everyone's going to receive because if it's not just personal, it'll be corporate. But nonetheless, everyone's going to get it.
Amen.
Amen.
Right?
Amen.
And then before
Amen.
You know it, it'll be 2022.
Do
you believe it, guys? 2022.
Hard to believe.
Wow.
It's already here.
So as you are, feel free to keep making comments and hitting that like button. We want to know you're there.
Yes.
And God's been so good to us this year. Yeah. He's been so
yes,
good to
is.
Us.
Yes, he is. Yes, he has.
So good to us. All right. Well,
Faithful
I love
God.
Amen. I love you, my love.
I love you.
And I'll see you in just
Excited about the word.
Amen. Well, speaking about the word.
Bless you. Love you.
Love you, too. Speaking about the word, let's try a little something different tonight. And again, of course, those recovering from all these tornadoes that took place, oh, my Lord, from Arkansas to Missouri, Tennessee, Kentucky, Illinois, and a few other states around. In Jesus' name, we declare their healing and recovery in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, we do. But tonight is a special night as well because today is Amy's birthday. Amy, come here. Come here real quick. And the people want to take a minute and they want to wish you a happy birthday.
Oh, my family. It's a good day to have a birthday. And not just any day, it's a Wednesday. So I get to celebrate my birthday in God's house with each and every one of you. That's awesome. That's awesome. I receive your blessings, church. I love you so much. You're not just church, you're family. And oh, my heart just loves each and every one of you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I'm reading all your beautiful messages. Thank you. Do you want to know how old I am? Nah, we'll skip that. I'm 41. Don't look at the gray hairs. Oh, I love you all. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Amy, just give us one. Just give us one Delta. Just give us one Delta. You know, we hear about the Delta, COVID Delta. We don't want to hear about the COVID. We want to hear about this Delta.
Oh, you. Anybody home? Oh, I just want to say thank you to all you little dumplings out there. You and you.
because I just love each and every one of you, just like the big majestic monarch butterfly loves to fly through the air. I love you even more than that. I love you, my little pumpkin dumplings.
That was good, Amy. Oh, that was good. That was good.
Love you, family.
Yep. And we thank the Lord that we are a church body, that we pray for each other, and we prayed for Amy and her family, and they're all well.
Amen.
And not just on the comeback trail. It's good to be on the comeback trail, but they are all well in the mighty name of Jesus. All right. All right, let's do something here for a few minutes and let's see where this goes. Let's see where this goes. Who has a favorite Bible verse? Now, you don't have to say the actual verse, but just if it's, say, John 3:16 or Amos 3:7 or 1 John 2:2. I'm just throwing scriptures out there, but who has a favorite Bible verse? And why don't you just comment that right now. What is your favorite Bible verse? And Pastor Derek, if you could take a paper and pencil or pen and write down people's favorite Bible verses. There we go. Okay, here we go. Proverbs 3:5-6. Proverbs 3:5-6. Write that down, Pastor Derek. Psalm 91. Write that down, Pastor Derek. Philippians 4:13. Write that down. The 23rd Psalm. Write that down. Philippians 1:6. Write that down. Galatians 2:20. Write that down. Psalm 84:11. Psalm 84:11. Write that down. Psalm 119:105. There we go. Just a few more, and then we're going to move on from there. There you go. Psalm 119:105. Did you get that?
Yes.
All right. A couple more. All right. Proverbs 11:24-25. Proverbs 11:24-25. Ephesians 2:10. Psalm 51, that's a great chapter, by the way, yeah. Ephesians 4:11. Acts chapter 3, that's a great one. The whole chapter is great, yeah. But favorite verse, okay, Psalm 103:1-3. Psalm 103, verses 1, 2, and 3. The 23rd Psalm, yeah, good stuff, yep. Habakkuk 2:2, yep. Write that down, Pastor Derek. Okay, Hebrews 10:24-25. Hebrews 10:24-25, there we go. Ephesians 3:20, there you go. Ephesians 3:20, you got that?
Yep.
How about Matthew 7:1? There you go, Matthew 7:1, you got that?
Okay.
Psalm 46, that whole chapter, we love that, yeah. Matthew 6:25, there you go. Whoa, we're getting a whole bunch here, guys. All right. Okay, we're going to move on now, okay? All right. There we go. Okay, good going, guys. Wow, that was quick. Okay, you got Matthew 6:25?
Yes.
You got that one? All right, very good. Okay, so you guys are helping me preach tonight. I love it. Okay, Pastor Derek, what was the first one? From just my remembrance, I think it was Proverbs 3?
Yes.
Proverbs 3, there you go. Okay. And that was Proverbs what, 3?
3:5-6.
There we go. Okay, now guys, you call them out, and here they go. Proverbs 3:5-6. Here's a word for you. Trust in the Lord with all of your heart. Trust in the Lord with all of your heart and lean not to your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him and he will direct your path. All right. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not to your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he will direct your path. Boy, that says a lot there, doesn't it? That says a lot. To trust in the Lord with not just your body, not just your mind, but with all your heart. And don't lean on your own understanding. In other words, don't try and figure it out. Don't try and figure it out. But in all your ways, and how many of your ways? All your ways, acknowledge him, and he will direct your path. Isn't that exciting?
Yes.
He will direct your path. Amen. So be encouraged. He's the path director. Somebody comment. He's the path director. Yes, not the past, but the path. He directs your path. The steps of the righteous are ordered of the Lord. Amen. What was the next one, Pastor Derek?
Psalm 91.
Psalm 91. Wow, that's a whole chapter there. So we'll just see where we go with that one there. I love Psalm 91. Yep. I love Psalm 91. Oh, yeah. He who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty, El Shaddai. I will speak of the Lord. That's for you, for me, for us. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge, my fortress, my God. I can preach this now. My God, in him will I trust.
Yes.
Surely he will deliver you from the snare of the fowler, from the enemy, and from the perilous pestilence, every demon, every devil, every sickness, every disease. He will cover you with his feathers. Under his wings you shall take refuge.
Yes, Lord.
Oh, this is good stuff. You guys are doing the preaching tonight. I'm just speaking out what you already commented. Yep. Under his wings you'll take refuge. His truth shall be your shield, your guide, your buckler.
Yes.
Yeah, that is true. That is true. Your buckler is a small shield. So we have big shields and small shields. Yep, we have big darts and small darts. But from all the darts, you are protected.
Yes.
This is good stuff. You shall not be afraid. I like this. You shall not be afraid of the terror by night, nor by the arrow that flies by day. So in other words, day or night, you have nothing to worry about. He's got you covered, night and day, day and night.
Amen.
Yep, nor of the pestilence that walks in darkness. Mm-hmm. You're not going to get tripped up in the darkness because God's got your back. Nor of the destruction that lays waste by noonday. So again, morning, noon, and night, God's got you. All right.
Amen.
1,000 may fall on your side, 10,000 at your right hand. It's the truth. 10,000 devils, 10,000 infirmities, 10,000 of thoughts. Right, Lori? 6,200 thoughts a day. Lori, you have a birthday on Sunday. Happy birthday. In advance, happy birthday, Lori. Our precious Lori in Texas, who's really in her spirit with us right here, right now.
Yes.
Her birthday is Sunday. Happy birthday. Yep. 1,000 may fall by your side. I say that because, you know, the Lord used you as our fact checker at 6,200 thoughts a day coming to our mind. Well, here we go. 1,000 may fall at your side, 1,000 of those thoughts, 6,200 of those thoughts, even more. 1,000 may fall by your side, but it shall not come near you. It shall not come near you. They'll fall by your side, they'll fall by your right hand, but they will not touch you. I like this. Listen to this. Verse 8, only with your eyes shall you look and see the reward of the wicked. There you go. In other words, you'll watch it, but it's not going to happen to you in Jesus' name. Because you have made the Lord, who is my refuge, even the Most High, your dwelling place. I like that. He's more than just our visitation. He's our habitation. He's more than just our guest. He lives in us. Mm-hmm. No evil shall befall you, nor shall... I like this one, especially now, what we're going through in America. Verse 10, nor shall any plague come near your dwelling in Jesus' name. And if it has, it's got to go.
Got to go.
I like this. That's verse 10. Verse 11, for he will give his angels charge over you. Charge! Somebody shout, charge!
Charge!
He'll give his angels charge over you to keep you in all your ways. In all your ways. In their hands they shall bear you up, lest you dash your foot against a stone. You shall tread upon the lion and the cobra, and the young lion and the serpent, the snake, the devil. You shall trample underfoot. Somebody comment, the devil's under my feet. Somebody comment, the devil is under my feet. Somebody comment, the devil's under my feet. Yep, yep. Verse 14, well, still in Psalm 91. Because you have set your love upon the Lord. Listen to this. Because he has set his love upon me. That's you putting your love upon the Lord. Because you're so in love with him. Therefore, I will deliver you. What a trade. I love him, and he delivers me. Charge! There you go. Yep. Because he has set his love upon me, therefore I will deliver him. I will set him on high, because he has known my name. We know that name. We identify with that name. The name above every name. The name of Jesus. That every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess. Jesus, Jesus. Because we set our love upon him, he will deliver us. That's why it's important to love him and stay in love with him. Yeah. Yep. He says, I will set you on high because you know his name. You identify with his name. You understand the revelation of the name of Jesus. You don't just say the name, but you know the authority of that name. Mm-hmm. Yep. Verse 15, he shall call upon me and I will answer him. Tonight, Lord, we've called upon you and you're answering us. Yep. Yep. We're calling upon him and he's answering us. That's why it's important when we say, let's pray. And we call upon him, he answers us, and he's doing it even now. He's doing it even now. Glory be to Jesus forevermore. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him. God is answering us. God is answering us. I love this. Again, still in verse 15. I will be with him in trouble. If you're ever in trouble, he's there. He's with you. He's with you. Yeah. You ever go through seasons of trouble? He's there. Yeah. He's with you. Look at this. Not only will I deliver you in time of trouble, verse 15 of Psalm 91, I will deliver him, meaning you, and honor. We've been talking about honor, right? God will honor you. Oh, when you're staying in love with him, staying in love with him. I love my wife, but I'm in love with her. I love my Lord, but I'm in love with him. We're in love with him, especially this Christmas season. Let's just fall in love with him over and over again. Yes. There's an old song we used to sing. Pastor Derek, I don't know if you know this song.
I keep falling in love with him over and over and over again. That one?
I keep falling in love with him over and over and over and over again. He gets sweeter and sweeter as the day goes by. Oh, what a love between my Lord and I. I keep falling in love with him over and over and over and over again. Ba-bop. Very good. You know that one.
I know that one.
Yay. Pastor Derek knows it. I thought you would. He will deliver you and honor you. We just keep falling in love with him. And he will not only deliver you. Look at this. Look at this double blessing here. He will deliver you from trouble and he will honor you. Kabod. He'll give you what you really, really want, what your heart's desire really, really wants. Delight yourself in the Lord and he will give you the desires of your heart. Yep. And he will deliver you and honor you. That's amazing. What a God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve.
Angels bow before him, heaven and earth adore him. What a mighty God we serve. There we go. He'll deliver you, he will honor you. Verse 16, and that's all of Psalm 91. There's 16 verses. We did the whole chapter. With long life, I will satisfy him. Folks, I don't want just long life. I want satisfied life.
Yes.
I want satisfied life, satisfaction. With long life, he will satisfy you, and he will show you his salvation. Not only being born again, but salvation meaning deliverance every time to the glory of God. I know sometimes things happen in life we don't understand, but God's word is still true. Amen. With long life, I will satisfy him and show him my salvation. God wants to show off his power to you. God wants to show off his miracles to you and his blessings to you. So thank you for bringing that up, Psalm 91. Thank you for commenting that. Thank you for commenting on Proverbs 3, 5, and 6. What was the next one, Pastor Derek?
Philippians 4:13.
I think many of us know this one, right? Many of those of us know this one, but if you don't, you're going to know it now. Philippians 4:13. But when I say it, I think all of you are going to know it just about anyway. And that is what? I can do all things through Christ. That's the importance that we need to remember. It's through Christ. I cannot do all things, but I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Who strengthens you?
Christ.
Who strengthens you?
Christ.
Christ strengthens you, right? Amen. Who strengthens you? Christ strengthens you. And then you're able to do all things. How many things?
All.
How many?
All
things. Why? Because it's who? It's through Christ. See, I can't do it without Christ. It's all through Christ. Through Christ, I can do all things. Amen. So that was your comment, and we read that verse. And let all of these be an encouragement to you tonight. Amen. Next one, Pastor Derek.
Psalm 23.
Oh, the 23rd Psalm. Yeah, yeah. Let's just read that entire chapter. How's that? The 23rd Psalm. I love that 23rd Psalm. You know, guys, there's so much revelation in these verses. And you guys are tempting me to preach now. Look at all this. The 23rd Psalm. The Lord is my shepherd. I love that. He is my shepherd. I may be your shepherd here as I am now, but the Lord is your great shepherd. Mm-hmm. I may be your pastor, but he is your great shepherd. Mm-hmm. I may be a shepherd, but he's the shepherd. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. I shall not want, meaning I shall not be in need. He is my all in all, my chief shepherd. I shall not want or be in need. He makes me or he helps me to lie down in green pastures. I love green pastures, don't you? He allows me to lie down, not just sit, but to lie down. To lie down, whether it be at night when you go to bed or during the day, metaphorically, during the day, you can be lying down in his presence, even at work. Lying down metaphorically, meaning that you can just rest in the Lord at all times. Rest in the Lord at all times. And he leads me besides the still and quiet waters. Ah, the peaceful waters of the Spirit. And remember, he is the water of life, Jesus is. And he gives you waters. In other words, be not only himself, but he'll lead you into greater peace, greater joy. He multiplies himself. How's that? He multiplies himself in you, where you walk in great peace. Where all of us together corporately walk in great peace. He leads us beside still waters, where we are like Christ, so we become like waters of life for those who are thirsty.
waters of life for those in need. Yes, he is the great water, but he leads us to waters, scriptures, waters, scripture verses like you're sharing tonight are waters of life, and he leads you. The great water maker himself, the great water of life, leads us into other waters, other scriptures, other people that we allow to water us, and we water them to the glory of the Lord. All right. He restores my soul. Isn't that beautiful? That whatever your soul's been through, if your soul's been vexed, he restores your soul. If you've been on an emotional roller coaster ride, like we've been over the last almost 2 years in America, he restores your soul. If your son or daughter or family, if your child is going through something, he restores your soul. I'm prophesying right now, there's somebody watching. Your daughter is going through something. And listen, anybody can say that, and anybody can say, well, that can be for any daughter. And you know, there's some truth to that, but I'm prophesying to somebody directly, he's restoring your daughter. Be at peace. Be at peace. She may not look like the way you want her to look like right now. Well, remember, there was a time that you didn't look like the way God wanted you to look like back then. And the same for me. But he's got her back. I felt like saying, he's got her back. He's got their backs. He's got all of your children's backs, fronts and sides. And he's going to restore them as well. He's not only protecting them, that's one thing, but he's restoring them as well. Guys, thank you for giving me these verses. Thank you. Woo! Yes. All right. He restores our souls. He leads me in paths of righteousness, not unrighteousness, righteousness. For his name's sake, we've shared a few weeks ago about his name's sake, for his honor, for his glory. Mm-hmm. And yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. Remember this, folks, it's only a valley. I said it's only a valley. Yea, though I walk through the valley. Look at this. You're walking through it, which means you're going to get through it. Yep. You're walking through it because you're going to get through it. This too shall pass. Somebody comment. This too shall pass. Yep. And he has not only your back, but he has your children's back, your family's back as well. Mm-hmm. He's got your baby's back. He's got your baby back. He's got your baby back. Do you remember that commercial, baby back ribs? What was that? Chili's. Chili's. Remember the commercial for Chili's? I want my baby back. Baby back, baby back, baby back. Well, they're talking about ribs, right? Well, ribs are in the Bible. That's where Eve came from, right? From Adam's Eve. From Adam's rib, right? But listen, seriously, he's got your baby back.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. He's not only protecting your baby, but he's going to restore your baby. He's got your baby back. Somebody comment. He's got my baby back. All right. This is good stuff. Thanks, guys. All right. This is good. You are with me. There's nothing to fear because the Lord is with you. I'll say it again. This is not just a verse. It is a verse, but it's revelatory. It's rhema. I will fear no evil because you are with me. So always know he's with you. So there's nothing to worry about. I said there's nothing to worry about because he's with you. And on top of that, he said, I'll never leave you. I'll never forsake you. This is good stuff. His word is good stuff. I love it. It's good stuff, his word. Yep. Mm-hmm. You didn't know how you were going to be used of the Lord tonight, right? To not only give, but to receive as well. Yep. For you are with me, I'll fear no evil. You are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. His word comforts you. His word sometimes corrects you and leads you and guides you. Sometimes he gives you a little poke, right? But here it says his word or his rod and a staff, they comfort you. They bring you comfort. They bring you exhortation. Ultimately, the comfort. His rod brings you rebuke. Why? To ultimately comfort you. Ultimately, yeah. God doesn't want to hurt you. He's not in the hurting business. He's in the helping business. I'll say it again. God is not in the hurting business. He's in the helping business. He's in the healing business. All right. Oh, I love this. He prepares a table before me in the presence of my enemies. which means you'll be able to see your enemies, but they cannot harm you.
Amen.
You'll be able to see your enemies, and they will not harm you. In fact, you'll even be able to eat and enjoy your meal. Even though your enemies are trying to come against you, those demonic forces, he anoints your head with oil. Oh, I love that. That's so anointed right now just to hear that. He anoints your head with oil. Remember Aaron the priest in Psalm 133? He anointed Aaron the priest's head and it fell on the rest of the body, those who were in position. God changed their condition. Yep. He anoints your head with oil. That means he gives you a fresh anointing over your mind, over your soul, over your body, spirit, soul, and body. Fresh anointing. And your cups run over. Now, I don't know if you think, I'm not sure if you know this one, Pastor Derek, but when I was a little boy in Sunday school, we used to sing a song, run, and it went like this, running over, run. You don't know it, Pastor Derek,
no, huh? Not what I don't know.
You don't know that, that's okay. And when I grew up in my Assembly of God church, there was a song, running over, running over. My cup is full of running over. Since the Lord saved me, I'm as happy as can be. My cup is full of running over. Anybody learned that song in Sunday school like 60 years ago? Anybody? 50 years ago? Ooh, I'm that old. Running over, running over. My cup is full of running over. Since the Lord saved me, I'm as happy as can be. My cup is full of running over. There you go. See, with these scriptures tonight, you get songs too. See that? All right. But you anoint my head with oil, my cup runs over. And I love this. Verse 6, and this is where Psalm 23 ends. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me some of the days of my life.
All.
Most of the days of my life.
All.
All the days of my life. I have two angels by my side. I even know their names. Did you know you have two angels by your side? I can tell you their names. Goodness and mercy. For surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life.
That's three angels.
Shirley. Oh, Shirley. Oh, Pastor Derek. You get that? Shirley? Okay, so Shirley, goodness and mercy. Pastor Derek, you are too funny. But really, God will give you a legion of angels.
Yes.
And when I say Shirley, goodness and mercy, I really don't know if that's their names, but they do have names. But we'll say tonight, Shirley, and Laverne too. Laverne and Shirley? No! Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life.
Shirley
He's given
McElvain.
You... Shirley who?
McElvain.
Shirley McElvain.
Grandma Shirley.
Oh, Grandma Shirley. Never mind, folks. Grandma Shirley is a dear woman of God that we know in Branson, Missouri. All right, Pastor Joni, keep your mask on, okay? All right. We're having a good time. We love Grandma Shirley. When our kids were real young in Branson, she would be our waitress at Silver Dollar City. Anyway, surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. Be encouraged, folks. All the days of your life. I love this. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. And that is true. That is true. Because even when you go home to be with the Lord, you're going to be in his house. So we're in his house now, and we're going to be in his house in the future. So this psalm is so true. Psalm 23:6, I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. And ever means ever. Whether here on earth, we're the temple of the Holy Spirit, we are in his house, we are the temple, his house, we come to his house, we are his house, but we're going to be in heaven forever. Folks, you can't lose with this stuff. You know what? These verses are encouraging me tonight as well. They're lifting me up and building me up as well. All right, next one, Pastor Derek.
Philippians 1:6.
Yeah, that's one of my favorite. And I prophesy that sometimes to people. Philippians 1:6. I'm going to go to it. I have it memorized, but I'm just going to go to it to give you time if you want to find it or just to keep commenting. Being confident, Philippians 1:6, being confident of this very thing, whatever that thing is that you're believing for, whatever that thing is, whatever that miracle you need, being confident of this very thing, in addition to that whatever thing is, this thing most of all, and that is being confident of this very thing. What is the ultimate thing? That he, capital H, he, the Lord, who began a good work in you. What kind of work?
Good.
What kind of work?
Good
work in you. We'll complete it until the day of Jesus Christ. So in other words, you may be a work in progress, but God will complete that work in progress. From now until the Lord takes you home or the rapture of the church takes place, he who began a good work in you. He's begun a good work in you. Sometimes it may not feel good, may not seem good, but it's good if it's of God. And he who began a good work in you will complete it. So be encouraged. Be very encouraged. He's going to complete the work. If the healing's begun, he's going to complete it.
Amen.
Deliverance
Amen.
Begun, he will complete it
yes,
in Jesus'
will.
Name.
Yes, he will.
Next one, Pastor Derek.
Galatians 2:20.
Oh, you know what? Galatians 2:20 was my favorite verse in Bible college. Galatians 2:20 was my favorite verse in Bible college. And every year in our yearbook, we had to put down our favorite verse. And I would put down Galatians chapter 2, verse 20. And Galatians 2:20 is something that I pray every day. I pray Galatians 2:20 every day. I have been crucified with Christ. Yet it is no longer I who live, but it is Christ who lives in me. Christ in me, the hope of glory. And the life in which I now live in the ordinary, as we know it, I live by the faith of the Son of God. I love this. Who loved me and he gave himself for me. Let's say that. I am crucified with Christ. Let's say it.
I am
crucified
with Christ.
That's right. Because when you've been crucified with Christ, your flesh cannot prevail. That means you can't get offended. That means you can't get jealous when you're crucified with Christ. That's why Paul said, I die yearly, right?
No.
Monthly?
No.
Daily, right? Sometimes we have to die every hour.
Yeah, hourly.
Sometimes by the minute. Mm-hmm. I've been crucified with Christ, yet it is no longer I. So it's Christ at alive in you. It's Christ at work in you. And when you die to self, you realize it's only through him that you can make it. And so that he can get all the glory and only him. Only him. All right. And the life that I live in the natural, I do it through the Son of God who loved me and he gave himself for me. Amen. Any more, Pastor Derek?
We got a whole list more.
Oh, list more. Well, let's go on.
Psalm 84:11.
Okay, I know that one, but we're going to find that. Psalm 84:11. Here we go. Okay. For the Lord God is a sun and shield. Psalm 84:11. For the Lord God is a sun and shield. I love this. The Lord will give grace and glory. Grace and glory. There's a double blessing. Grace and glory. Huh?
Amen.
But listen to the end. And no good thing will he withhold.
Yes.
From who? To those who walk uprightly.
Mm-hmm.
To those who honor him. When it comes time to serving, serve. When it comes time to pay the tithe, pay it. When it comes time to sow the seed, sow it. When it comes time to sharing your testimony, share it. When it comes time to witnessing to somebody, do it. No good thing will he withhold to those who walk uprightly. That means, man, He's got a lot in store for you. He's got a lot in store for you. He really, really does. Next, Pastor Derek.
Next, Psalm 119, 105.
Psalm 119, 105. I know that one. I'm going to turn to that one. Psalm 119, 105. I'm going to give you a little story about that too. Psalm 119, 105. Your word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Your word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Here's a story, true story. In the Bible days, they had lanterns, and they would walk with lanterns. But especially when it got darker, they would tie those lanterns over their ankles. They would tie the lanterns. See, like today we use flashlights. They had lanterns, but when it got really dark, they would tie it around their ankle, and they would walk with the lantern attached to their ankle, attached to their foot. And that's what you call walking by faith. Walking by faith. There was an old professor that told me years ago from Northwestern Bible College of the Assemblies of God in Minnesota. Or as Pastor Derek would say,
Minnesota.
He said, go walk as far as you can see and see how far you will go. But we do that by faith, by faith. But in the Bible, they had a lantern around their ankle and they can only see the next step in front of them. Catch that. Because many times we want to see the big picture. And the Lord says, one piece at a time, one step at a time. And then before you know it, you'll see the complete puzzle. Sometimes he shows you more, but many times it's just one step at a time. Like what I prophesied over Pastor Eddie this past Sunday. One step at a time. You get it. One step at a time for each and every one of us. Your word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path, which means you will not stumble because he will not lead you in darkness. And what's the lamp? His word. He is the light of the world, right? Okay. Next one, Pastor Derek.
Proverbs 11, 24 and 25.
I love those. Oh, I love those verses. I love those verses. Mm-hmm. Proverbs 11, 24 and 25. Many times I use these two verses when it's time to receive the tithes and the offerings. Proverbs 11, 24 and 25, right?
Yes.
Okay. There is one who scatters, who sows, yet increases more. In other words, they keep sowing and sowing, but yet God keeps them giving, gives them back more and more and more. More than they can sow, God gives them more in the harvest, even more than they can sow. There's one who scatters, yet increases more. Listen to this. And there is one who withholds more than what is right. In other words, there are some that give, but don't give the way God said to give. You see what I'm saying? They give, but they hold back in their giving. That's not good. And that leads to poverty. Now, I'm just quoting scriptures that you guys gave me, right? It leads to poverty. Love verse 25. But the generous soul shall be made rich, fat, abundantly blessed to the glory of God. But this would be a good time to receive the tithes and offerings, wouldn't it? But we're not done. Good. I love this. Proverbs 11, 24 and 25. There is one who scatters. They sow, but God gives them even more because he supplies seed to the sower. And there is one who withholds more than what is right. Maybe they tip God. I don't know. But the generous person will be made rich. You'll have more than enough. More than enough in every area of your life. Claim that in Jesus' name. But we have to apply what this verse just said. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Faith without works is dead. We got to do it. And I believe we do. And if you don't, do it. Amen. Next, Pastor?
Ephesians 2:10.
Ephesians 2:10. Boy, we got a lot of verses here. I love this verse. Ephesians chapter 2. We're having a good time in the word of the Lord. See what we're doing? We're soaking it up. Did you see my Facebook post today?
Yeah. Yes.
We're soaking it up. Like a sponge. That was Ephesians 2:10, right?
Yes.
I love this verse. I love this verse. For we are his workmanship. Mm-hmm. We work for him. We are his workmanship. We were created in Christ Jesus for good works. Mm-hmm. That's why he created us, to do good things. To do good things. For his kingdom, to build his kingdom, to help other people, to pray for those in need. We were created for his workmanship. We are a work in progress. We are workers in the kingdom. The harvest is ripe, but the laborers are few. But according to this, we're workmen, we'll be workmen, workwomen, workmen for his kingdom. We're created to work for him, for Christ Jesus, for good works, not for evil, not for bad, for good works, which God prepared beforehand that we should walk in them. In other words, God gave you an assignment before you even knew him. God has given us an assignment even now for us to fulfill. We're doing it in Jesus' name. We're going to do it because we're crucified with Christ, because the Lord is our shepherd. You get it. Next, Pastor Derek.
The next one,
Psalm 51. Psalm 51. Oh, yeah. I love Psalm 51. I love Psalm 51. Let's see how much we'll get to that. Psalm 51. Great chapter. Great, great chapter. I love this chapter so much. Yep, Psalm 51. Yep. We're going to read a few verses from Psalm 51. We'll read a few of these verses here. Verse 1, Lord, have mercy on me. Yep. Somebody say out loud, Lord, have mercy on me. Say it out loud. Lord, have mercy on me. Oh God, according to your loving kindness, according to the multitude of your tender mercies, I love this, blot out my transgressions. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquity. Remember last week I spoke about emotional punishment? Yep. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquity and cleanse me from my sin. For I acknowledge my transgression. Folks, we have to acknowledge our transgressions. You know, sometimes we just say, Lord, I'm sorry. Here's a word. Lord, please forgive me. And he does. But sometimes we have to acknowledge what it is. That's why the Bible says, confess your faults one with another. Sometimes we have to acknowledge what it is that we did to identify it so that it can be crucified. Not just generalize it, but sometimes we have to call it out. You get it? Well, I'm sure glad you guys gave me these verses. Yeah. Wash me, blot out my transgressions. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquities. Thoroughly cleanse me, Lord. That's a process. Cleanse me from my sin. Listen to this. For I acknowledge my transgression. That's what we just said. We acknowledge it. We acknowledge it. And my sin is always before me. You see, until it's dealt with, it's going to remain there. Until it's dealt with, it's going to remain there. We're getting prophetic here in the word of the Lord. Against you and only you have I sinned. Well, for those of you that don't know it, Psalm 51 was really written by David, and it was really his psalm of repentance for committing adultery with Bathsheba and having her husband killed. Yep. Okay. Behold, I was brought forth in iniquity, and in sin my mother conceived me. Behold, you desire truth in my inward parts. Think about that, folks. We want the truth of God's word to be in our inward parts. In every fiber of our being, we want his truth to be manifested. Mm-hmm. And in your hidden parts, you will make me know your wisdom. You will know, make me know your wisdom. I'm going to drop down to verse 10. Create in me a clean heart, O Lord. I love this. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a steadfast spirit in me. Let's make that our prayer right now. Create in me a clean heart, O God. As we're nearing the end of this year, Lord, create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a steadfast spirit in me. Take not your Holy Spirit from me. Cast me not away from your presence. Cast me not away from your presence. Don't take your Holy Spirit from me. And he won't in Jesus' name, because verse 12 says he's going to restore us and he's going to restore the joy of our salvation.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Yes. Amen. And then I'm going to drop down to verse 17 for time's sake. The sacrifices of God are a broken spirit. I could not ignore. We don't mean to ignore any of these verses, but there's only so much we can give in one night. But verse 17, the sacrifices of God are a broken spirit and a broken and contrite heart. These things he will not despise. So folks, if there's anything we need, it's a broken spirit before God. I don't mean for you to be heartbroken, but I mean to break in his presence, to say, Lord, mold me, make me, shape me, break me, and form me into your image. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Any others, Pastor Derek?
Ephesians 4:11.
Yep. I love that one. Ephesians 4:11. Yeah, there's a lot to go with Ephesians 4:11. And he himself gave some to be apostles, prophets, evangelists, pastors, and teachers. Yes, he has. For the equipping of the saints, right? For us to equip you. My job is to equip you for ministry, right? Right. And thank God you guys are teachable. Amen. What else, Pastor Derek? Any others?
Somebody said Acts 3.
Acts chapter 3, yeah. That was the day of Pentecost. That was the day. Well, actually, no. The day of Pentecost. Is that all you have written down? That's all you have written down? Okay. In my spirit, I seen in my spirit a couple more. In my spirit. And that's okay. Did somebody give me Habakkuk 2:2? Did somebody give me Habakkuk 2:2? Did somebody give me Matthew 7:1? Was Matthew 7:1?
Yes.
Yeah? Okay.
Yes.
I just want to make sure everyone that come, I want to get to. Okay, and thank you, Pastor Derek, for doing the best you could. But I believe somebody gave me Habakkuk 2:2. Is that right?
Yes.
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 Okay, then I'm going to give Habakkuk 2:2. Thank you, Pastor Derek. Then the Lord answered me and said, "Write the vision and make it plain on tablets, that you may run who read it." I'm going to go to verse 3. Okay. For the vision is yet for an appointed time, but in the end it will speak and it will not lie. Though it tarries, wait for it, because it will surely come to pass.
Yes.
Surely come to pass. Surely again. Surely, Pastor Derek. Surely it will come to pass. That was Habakkuk 2:2. Then the Lord answered me and said, "Write the vision down and make it plain." Folks, write it down and it will come to pass. You know, I've been speaking for a long time. This virus has got to dry and die.
Yes.
I speak it, I speak it, I speak it, and it's going to come to pass in Jesus' name. And you keep speaking it as well.
Yes.
Amen. I believe somebody gave me Matthew 7:1.
Yes.
Is that correct?
That is correct.
Matthew 7:1. Okay. So I'm going to go there to Matthew 7:1. I know what it says, but I want to read it for that precious person who gave it. Okay, Matthew 7:1. Judge not, lest ye be judged. Judge not. I think it's time to continue to allow mercy to triumph over judgment. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Pastor Derek, you gave me one in Ephesians. What, another one you gave me?
Ephesians 3:20.
Ephesians 3:20. Yeah, I love that one. Ephesians 3:20. It's one of my favorites. I use this as a benediction sometimes, or a doxology, if you would. Now unto him who is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all you could ask, think, or dare to imagine. I like that. According to the power that works in us. Now unto him who is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all you could ask, think, or dare to imagine. According to the power that works within you. I'm going to read verse 21. To him, the Lord, be all the glory in the church by Christ Jesus to all generations. He's able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all you could ask, think, or dare to imagine. And Pastor Derek, you did say Acts chapter 3?
I did.
Yes. Well, we know in Acts chapter 1, the Holy Ghost was promised. Acts chapter 2, the Holy Ghost came down. And in Acts chapter 3, thousands were being led to the Lord.
Yeah.
And they fellowshiped from house to house, breaking bread. And church, I've been ministering on fellowship, about respect and honor and fellowship. And it's time to break bread in the realm of the Spirit. That's Holy Communion. But it's time to fellowship, to come to God's house and engage. High bread to all of us engaged together. And there's so much more that it says in Acts 3. There's so much here. But it said that through the hands of the apostles, miracles were brought forth. Signs and wonders were done through the apostles. Why? Because they continued in the apostles' doctrine and fellowship with each other. And God's house was blessed, and they were praising God. And it says here in the last verse I'm really quoting chapter 2, and the power of God fell and came down. That's Acts chapter 2. The power of God fell and came. But then in Acts 3, that's when a greater explosion took place. Somebody say greater explosion in Acts chapter 3. I'm so excited here. I'm giving you Acts 1. I'm giving you Acts 2. And I'm giving you Acts 3. But in Acts 3, it talks about the lame that were healed, Peter and John. At 3 o'clock in the afternoon, a man who was lame from his mother's womb, they were carried to him and he was healed. Oh, I'm telling you, there's so much here. And then the individual that said, you know, that was begging. And Peter said, silver and gold have we not, but such as we give you in the name of Jesus, rise up and walk. Rise up and walk in Jesus' mighty name. Yep. Yeah, there were those who were lame, sick, weak, those that were crippled, those that were blind, all sorts of people. But the word of the Lord here says, rise up and walk. Let me tell you about this. It wasn't not that Peter did not have the money, because God's disciples had money. You know, Jesus even had the treasurer, okay? But sometimes you have to say, you know what? Today's not your day to receive money. Today's the day to receive your miracle. Yes, we need money. We need money, but money can't buy me love. Can't buy me love. Money can't buy me love. All right. Yep. Yep. Oh, there's so much here. Yeah, there's so much here. There's so much here in Acts chapter 1, Acts chapter 2, Acts chapter 3. Yeah, and then of course, repent, therefore, be converted, that your sins may be blotted out, so that the times of refreshing may come from the presence of the Lord. That starts with repentance. That he may send Jesus Christ, who was preached to you before, whom heaven must we hold back or retain until the times and seasons of restorations of all things which God has spoken out of the mouth of his holy prophets. So you know what? I give you a little bit of Acts 1, Acts 2, and Acts 3. Any others, Pastor Derek?
Psalm 103.
Psalm 103. Are there any others after that?
There's three more?
Okay, I'm gonna get to you all. Psalm 103. Any particular verses?
1-3.
Bless Psalm 103.
Amen.
Forget none of his benefits. Who forgives all your iniquities. Who forgives all, I could preach on that. Who forgives all your iniquities. You see, folks, when we carry iniquities, then we need an inner healing. We spoke last week about psychological punishment, what was the other term I used last week? About punishment, emotional punishment, right?
Right?
Who heals all your diseases, all your diseases. I'm going to read verse 4 too. Who redeems your life from destruction, and he crowns you with loving kindness and tender mercies. Who satisfies your mouth with good things. Amen. So that your youth is renewed. Yes. Like the eagles.
Yes.
But bless the Lord, all my soul, and all that is within me. Forget none of his benefits, who forgives all your iniquities. So in other words, he was wounded for our transgressions, bruised for our iniquities. Chastisement of our peace was upon him. By his stripes we are healed. But he forgives us because sometimes there are things that we hold in. There are things that we hold in, and it causes us, if we're not careful, it causes us to get bitter if we're not careful. It causes us to not forgive if we're not careful. Go ahead, Pastor Derek.
Psalm 46.
Psalm 46. Any verse or just Psalm 46?
Just Psalm 46.
Okay, well, let's see Psalm 46. I've got a favorite one in Psalm 46. In fact, Psalm 46:10 is one of my favorites. Yeah, Psalm 46:10. Be still and know that I am God. Be still, relax. Lay down, like remember Psalm 23, just lay down. Be still and know that I am God, and I will be exalted among the nations, among the heathen. Yep, I like verse 1. God is our refuge, our strength, our very present help in time of trouble. Therefore, I will not fear, even though the earth be removed, though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea. There is a river whose stream shall make glad the cry, shall make glad the city of God, the holy place of the tabernacle of the Most High. There's a lot to preach in here, guys. There's so much here. I love it. This is all good. What else, Pastor Derek?
Matthew 6:25.
Oh, yes. Matthew 6:25, and we're just about done here. This has been rich.
Yes, it has.
Matthew what? 25 what?
6:25.
Oh, Matthew 6. Matthew 6:25. Oh, yeah, I know that. To the glory of God, I know that. For his honor and glory, Matthew 6:25. Therefore, I say to you, Encounter Church, those watching from coast to coast by the power of the Holy Ghost, we're going to be done here in a minute. But listen to this, Matthew 6:25. Therefore, I say to you, do not worry about your life. Come on, do not worry about your life. This is a word for me, a word for you, a word for us. Do not worry about your life. For what will you eat? What will you drink? Or about your body, or what you'll put in it? Is not life more than food and body? And the body more for clothing? I'll even read verse 26. For even the birds of the air, they neither sow nor reap nor gather into barns, yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you of not more value? This is rich stuff. Any others?
Hebrews 10:24-25.
Hebrews 10:24-25. I love those verses. Here we go. Hebrews 10:24-25. Let us consider one another in order to stir us up in love and in good works. That's fellowship, folks. And not forsaking the assembling together, as is the manner of some, but exhorting one another, so much more as you see that real evil day of the last of the last days, which is now approaching and upon us.
That's it, guys.
You did the preaching tonight. I just read the scriptures. Yay! Father, tonight may the word be sealed, the words of the Lord be sealed in these hearts and minds of these precious people. Father, for those that commented verses and those that did not, seal it now, we pray, my God. Seal it now, we pray, Father, in Jesus' name. And thank you, Lord, for this encouragement, we pray. Thank you, Lord, for this encouragement, we pray in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. It's sealed in Jesus' name. It's done. Good job, guys. Good job of engaging. Good job, Hybrid. Love you so much. Love you so much. And this Sunday, 10 a.m. sharp, you just don't know what's going to happen. God's glory may come down in different ways, shape, or forms. Then, of course, next Wednesday. Then, of course, Christmas Eve on the 24th from 3 to 4 o'clock in the afternoon. Right? And then the 26th, our Christmas service, we have gifts for everybody. And then New Year's Eve, it's going to explode. Amen. So now, let's worship the King of Kings and Lord of Lords with our tithes and offerings. I want to be the first. I want to be the first. Or maybe you already gave online. I'll be the second, the third. But now let's worship the Lord with our tithes and offerings. And we thank God that fruit abounds to your account. You can give online right now because you're not in the building. You're not in the building. So either drive around the church tonight or tomorrow morning, or you can give online. You can call the church. You can put it in the mail. But let's give for tonight. And let's see our continual harvest in Jesus' mighty name. Count the Church, Facebook friends, those in other cities, states, and nations and countries, we love you all. We love you all. Oh, and yeah, and Mama Bainer, I didn't forget you. If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves, seek my face, turn from their wicked ways, then will they hear from heaven, and I'll heal their land. 2 Chronicles 7:14. I love you all. You're the best in the Midwest or anywhere else. We're going to do this again some other time so others of you can share other verses as well. And I'll just share these verses and we'll minister on these verses. But we thank the Lord for your tremendous Thursday, fabulous Friday, sensational Saturday. We'll look for you, High Bread, Super Sunday, in Jesus' mighty name. And I speak multiplication now as we're able to sow our seed to the glory of God in Jesus' name. I love you so much. You're the best in the Midwest or anywhere else. And if our arms were long enough, we'd give you one big hug. If our lips were big enough, we'd give you one big kiss. We love you all so much. Now, if you gave this past Sunday for Wednesday, God bless you. But the rest of us, let's give tonight for tonight to the glory of God. He's so worthy. Love you so much. I declare multiplication of harvests of good things upon you like we did this past Sunday. Get ready for this Sunday. Love you. Adios. Good night. God bless you. Peace.